Hello everyone, I am Rishabh Shah and in this video I would like to explain what you as an investor should look at before buying dividend stocks for your portfolio. We have created a group of 5 best dividend stocks to buy: Bajaj Auto, GAIL, Hindustan Zinc, SJVN and ITC. This list of stocks is for a long-term horizon, keeping several fundamental factors in mind. As a beginner investor, this will guide you to make your own checklist and research these dividend stocks better. A dividend can be described as a reward that publicly listed companies give to their shareholders. Such rewards can either be in the form of cash, cash equivalents, shares, etc., and are mostly paid from the remaining share of profit once essential expenses are met. However, companies may decide to retain their accumulated profits to reinvest in the business or reserve it for the future use. Now, dividend stocks are companies that pay out regular dividends. They usually have a well-established track record of distributing earnings back to their shareholders. Dividend investing is a strategy that gives investors 2 sources of potential profit. 1. The predictable income from regular dividend payments, and 2. Capital appreciation over time. Stocks that pay dividends can be some of the safest to own, but there can be still be pitfalls, and dividend stocks can be risky if you don't know what to avoid. Not every dividend stock can maintain a payout in every economic environment, something that the COVID-19 pandemic has demonstrated. But a diversified portfolio of dividend stocks can give you a steady income. Moving forward, let's look at the things to consider before choosing a profitable dividend stock. The dividend payout ratio is the proportion of earnings paid out as dividends to shareholders, typically expressed as a percentage. Several considerations go into interpreting this ratio, most importantly the company's level of maturity. The company should at least have a dividend payout ratio of 40%. Looking at the companies in our model portfolio, they have declared lofty dividend payout ratios, making them great dividend stocks. Although GAIL has a ratio of 31%, we still have included it in our model portfolio because of its superior dividend yield of 6.69%. The dividend yield expressed as a percentage is a financial ratio which is derived by dividing dividend per share by the price per share. It shows how much a company pays out dividends each year relative to its stock price. Generally, dividend yield above 3% is a good benchmark for your portfolio. It is also important for investors to keep in mind that higher dividend yields do not always indicate attractive investment opportunities, because the yield of a stock may be elevated as the result of a declining stock price. As you can see, the stocks in our model portfolio have a dividend yield in the range of 4-8%, which is excellent. The company should also have a fair track record when it comes to offering dividends and paying off debts. Stability or regularity of dividends is considered as a desirable policy by the management of most companies. Shareholders also value stable dividends higher than the fluctuating ones. However, if suddenly dividends reduced, an investor must check what the free cash is used for instead. A consistent decline in dividend payout ratio should be checked and not neglected by the investors. Looking at an example of ITC, the company has consistently maintained a dividend payout ratio of around 55%, except for the 2 years where it paid out even more. This is a really strong track record, and investors can assume this trend to continue. Dividend stocks carry some risks too. One of them being share prices can drop. Now, this situation is possible regardless of whether the company pays dividends. Worst case scenario is that the company goes bankrupt before you have the chance to sell your shares. Companies can also trim or slash dividend payments at any time. They are not legally required to pay dividends or increase the payments they make. Unlike bonds, where a failure to pay interest can put a company into default, a company can cut or eliminate a dividend whenever it wants. Thirdly, not investing your money or investing in something that doesn't keep the pace with inflation causes your investment capital to lose purchasing power. Therefore, it is important for dividends paid to grow consistently as well. However, Don't buy stocks only for their dividends. It is essential to do a sanity check of other fundamental factors such as strong revenue and PAT growth, robust operating margins, minimal debt, and also not a very capital intensive business, as high capex can lead to lower dividends for shareholders. A basic check on fundamentals is a must, even for dividend stocks as a strategy. Thank you.